Hey everybody, Dutch Sense here. It is 1:33 p.m. Central Time on Thursday, September 15th, 2011. And we're looking at the last 14 days of earthquakes fed through the United States Geological Survey, and I have the magnitudes turned up to 6.0 and greater. And we see on the map, over the last 14 days, 13 6.0 and greater earthquakes. Now, of course, the Western Pacific is showing the most activity. We're seeing a lot of activity down near Vanuatu, right down through New Zealand, west through Indonesia, up into Indochina, and then right up through the Pacific Ring of Fire, you're seeing Japan, Alaska, and all the way over to Vancouver Island, British Columbia, a series of 6 and 7.0 earthquakes. Now the 6.8 that's showing here was actually a 7.1 and it was downgraded. Now there's a noticeable lack of 6.0s that have occurred from Vancouver south all the way to basically South America. Over the last 2 weeks there have not been any. As we go south, you look into Peru, Argentina, Chile, 6.7 in the last 2 weeks, and then right along the southern Mid-Atlantic Ridge in the South Sandwich Islands, you're looking at a 6.2. So what that says to me is, over the last 2 weeks, the entire Ring of Fire, minus the area of United States and Central America, has shown a tremendous amount of movement. Now, if I just knock it down to 5.0s here, you can see Central America has experienced movement, but not on the scale that the rest of the plate all the way around to the Western Pacific has. You can see 5s and borderline 6.0s occurring south, but again, Central America, north, all the way to Washington State, has been minus that activity. As we get over to Puerto Rico, you can see Puerto Rico has had basically 5.0 earthquakes, and one that even occurred out at the sea floor, where they don't normally have too many earthquakes, in the Atlantic. As we go east, you can see, following the fault line, right along north of Antarctica and going up into Africa. Africa has experienced a few 5.0s right offshore, and then of course North Africa right into the Mediterranean Sea, a series of 5.0s. Now if I knock it down just a little bit more to 4.0s, you can see Netherlands, you can see Turkey, you can see Greece, and then you see the series of 4s and 5s that have occurred right through the Middle East, through North India, and this is the Himalaya Mountains right in here. So what that means to me is that the entire Pacific plate is moving and it's putting pressure on these other plates, but the source of the problem lies in here. Now the cause, I do not know yet. I'm leaning towards a natural cause, most likely post-glacial rebound effect mixed with solar activity. And that in itself would be enough to produce a series of earthquakes like we're seeing. Now, let me just turn it down a few more, down to 3s, and then it really gives you a good idea of what's going on, specifically in the United States. Let's turn off the magnitude so you can just get a good idea of where these are occurring, and turn down the rings a little so you can see. And I've said this before, this curl that's occurring right here, this, well, noticeable edge, is the edge of the old unsubducted plate called the craton. And the earthquakes that are occurring right along the edge as the Pacific Ring of Fire is moving. It's putting pressure on the North American and South American plate. That in turn is having a spillover effect to the Mid-Atlantic Ridge, where on the other side you see these quakes that are coming across the Middle East and going right up through Europe. And that's again pressure from both sides from the movement all the way over here on the other side of the planet. So what I see is, when I look at the United States, I'd say any one of these states. So unfortunately, we're looking at Washington, Oregon, Idaho, Utah, Colorado, Texas, Oklahoma, Arkansas, Missouri, Illinois, Indiana, Tennessee, Kentucky, even down as far south as northern Mississippi, Alabama, Georgia, and then curling right back up through where we saw the earthquakes in Virginia, and going right up into southern Canada. That is the area we need to watch. It's a huge area for additional 4s and 5.0 earthquakes that could be felt by a lot of people. South America, same thing basically goes for South America. you're looking anywhere along this plate boundary, you're looking at additional, well, unfortunately, 5 to 6.0 earthquakes, possibly even a 7.0 the further south we go. Right in the middle, you see it, there's a plate boundary that occurs, and it's a fracture that goes right on over, and it terminates basically at Puerto Rico, where the swarm is occurring. Puerto Rico, you're looking at additional 5.0 and greater threat watch for the next several weeks. As we get into Europe, you can see it, the plate boundary up here beyond England, Norway, it's experiencing a swarm that's occurring right off the coast of Greenland, south of Iceland. Now, I would watch from the English Channel, north to Norway, and south to Spain and southern France, maybe even as far over as Gibraltar. Also, a diagonal line from southern France right up into Poland is an area you're going to want to watch for additional 4.0 earthquakes in light of the past 4.0s that just happened this past week. So right along here, right along through the Alps. As you get into southern Europe, of course, the area you're going to want to watch is Greece, into Turkey, and of course the Mediterranean Sea itself. This is all associated with volcanic activity, and the volcanoes, we'll get into that in just a moment. And, of course, anywhere through northern India, into China, southern Russia, right in this area here, 6.0 and greater, next 2 weeks. North of Australia, we just covered it, but we'll just cover it one more time. I'm watching anywhere along through north of Australia along this S-shaped plate boundary. And we're looking at 1 6.0 a day all the way along here, literally spaced out about every day to day and a half. So almost every 36 hours you're seeing it happen. Hawaii, you're going to continue to have the small earthquakes associated with the different flows occurring. I'll put some links down below so you can go check those out and watch the webcams at these different volcanoes. It's very interesting and very educational to watch. Now let's get over here and look at the Pacific Northwest. I received a report from one of my viewers on my main page saying that they live in Everett, Washington, and that they felt like their house has been moving, that there's been literally shaking occurring up in the area. So I came and looked at the charts, and here it is. You can see in the Everett, Washington area, you have several, at least 2 to 3.0 earthquakes, some extended for several minutes. And then you see this background activity that flares up. That to me says it's a sign of movement in the area, and that's associated with the additional 6.0s all the way around the Ring of Fire. I would say that the Cascadia Range is most likely getting ready to show some kind of large movement, and it's been building up for a while. We know California's due. So let's go down here and look at a few of the volcanoes, check those, see what they're showing. Okay, you can see here movement that's basically occurring over the course of 20 to 30 minutes. Now this is what is called harmonic movement. This is deep underground movement of magma, most likely. It could also be background elements from the 6.0s that have been occurring on the western Pacific, causing steady movement on the eastern side of the Pacific. Let's go look at another volcano down here. Okay, we're not getting anything on that station. Okay, let's check a different one here. Okay, and we're seeing basically the same kind of movement. You see this earthquake activity that's very noticeable. It's at least a 2 to 3.0 being registered, and then smaller ones and twos, and that's over the course of an entire 24-hour period. So you are looking at a fair amount of movement that's occurring in the Pacific Northwest. We can expect that, especially in light of all the activity that's occurring. Now let's also check, let's see here, Yellowstone, and see what Yellowstone's been showing. Now I'm not worried about an eruption at any of these places, we're worried about earthquake activity. So here's Yellowstone, this is current charts. Okay, we just had another earthquake here, where did that occur? 3.0 up in Alaska. Okay. So here's Yellowstone, and you can see the earthquake activity associated at Yellowstone. Again, a 2 or 3.0 earthquake, followed by smaller 1s and 2.0s. Okay, and let's go back. Here's Madison River. This pops up at the same time roughly every day. This to me says maybe geyser movement or other associated underground activity. Definitely large-scale movement over several hours. And if we go back a day, here's yesterday's charts. Look at Horse Butte. This says to me a large amount of movement over several hours, and this could even be a fresh geyser venting or some other literal volcanic activity that may not be reported in the mainstream media. And I base that upon what the chart has looked like in the past, which a day ago or 2 days ago was baseline. Baseline, hardly any reading, and then there you go, it flares up at roughly 2300 hours. Okay, and now let's go over all the way over to Europe and check the European charts, because Earthquake 3D does not show any kind of feed through the European agency. So let's pull that chart. Okay, and now we have several options. You can look at lists or you can look at maps. I prefer to look at maps. It gives you a better idea of what's going on around the world. So this is the last 48 hours of earthquakes reported in Europe. And you can see the area activity is basically from Greece over to Turkey, north into Poland. You're seeing some actual earthquakes occur here right at the border of Netherlands and Germany. And I did a video on that about a week ago showing that that's fairly close to a nuclear power plant, just by coincidence. Also, right into Switzerland and France. Small earthquake activity. So this is the area you want to watch. Anywhere through France into Poland, right along this line where I'm moving my mouse. Basically north of the Alps. And you'll want to watch that for additional 4.0 and greater earthquakes over the next 2 weeks. Okay, and let's just jump back over to Earthquake 3D, take one more quick look, and just look for your area. Wherever you live on the planet, look for your area here. I'll put a bunch of links down below, as many as I can find, and you can monitor the earthquake situation in your specific town or city. So, folks, hang in there, and much love. Make sure to have your preparedness plans ready if you do live in an earthquake zone. Have food, water, transportation. Make sure your loved ones also know the plan. That's the best we can do. Hang in there, folks.